Now something entirely different. By the way, we're the older generation in this thing. We get the chairs. They dance, we sit. So my name's Laurie. My ancient Cuisinart food processor died last month, and I totally fell apart. I use it maybe twice a year, and each time I remember the man who gave it to me, who was an early AIDS patient, and he became a friend. I didn't cry at his funeral because I'd already been to too many funerals. So more than 30 years later, after my machine broke, I cried for him and others. This is my story. 1980 to 1990, longtime lesbian, feminist, socialist hippie, moved here to San Francisco after 4 years in Santa Cruz as a college student, activist, cannery worker, women's health movement person, and an alcoholic and drug user. After working as a paralegal, I ended up in nursing school, kind of surprisingly, and then suddenly I'm a new nurse at San Francisco General and newly clean and sober. By 1982, my patients are suddenly my gay brothers, and they're sick with a new mystery disease. We the nurses and doctors, say, we will do our best to help you stay alive until we know what you have and how we will cure you. Meanwhile, death is everywhere. I provide nursing care, I write pamphlets, I give talks, I talk about risk factors and safe sex, I see my first condom. We demonstrate for more funding, for more medications, for a vaccine. We demonstrate putting condoms on eggplants to show that they're indeed big enough for everybody, which was an issue. We hold conferences on women at risk and lesbian caregivers and the AIDS epidemic. We experiment with using dental dams for oral sex with our women partners. We discover that it's almost impossible to use them. We can't practice on eggplants. Although I have to say, today I was reading the updated something edition of a lesbian sex book, and it actually had some really great ideas of how to make these things work. So I don't want to say that they don't work, even though I couldn't make them work.
Years of HIV and AIDS, there are still more questions than answers. I work in the county health department.
department managing some of the HIV programs in Santa Cruz. The epidemic changes in the U.S., but it doesn't go away. More treatments, more side effects, women, poverty, drug users. Many patients are co-infected with Hep C. Like most people with Hep C, I find out I have the virus in addition to the antibody, and I already have some liver damage. I come out of my Hep C closet, attend and speak at meetings for people with Hep C, and work to make sure that people co-infected with Hep C and HIV have treatment for both. I begin Hep C treatment. It's brutal, and I look and feel terrible, and I continue to keep working. My work is important, and I understand in a new way what people with HIV and cancer are going through. And I should mention now that the treatment for Hep C these days is less brutal, it's quicker, it works for people that have the most resistant type of Hep C, which is all very encouraging. The problem with it is it's hugely expensive, even more expensive than when I did it back 10 or so years ago, so we need to work on that. That was more than 10 years ago, and I was lucky. After two tries, the treatment was successful, and I have no measurable virus. Like people with HIV, I hesitate to use the word cure. Like a few of my original AIDS patients and friends in 1982, I'm still here. I want to send a special thanks to my friend in the audience who I have seen the whole time who's still here also. I'm still here, many of us are still here, and we continue to advocate for affordable medication, meal exchange, housing, mental health services, for people with HIV and Hep C, and for everybody. We're still here. Thank you. Thank you.